So I think it's actually like I think it's actually beneficial to like a community like or like a like fan base and also to like a company like a production company or film like studio to like redeem like villainous characters even if like so because like again like the mask that Callahan has is that like these they were like reusing the same characters but they weren't recycling them and I think that's also what was happening because like you know same-sex attraction and like they were trying to destroy gay people so like we already gone over that but I think that it's actually like beneficial to the studio to like redeem like villains in the stories or to at least like acknowledge like a like acknowledge like the story like or like acknowledge the unresolved stories and then like like just like construct like a more mature like perspective on the story because I think what that does is it like people like human beings like have memories like and like suppressing memories doesn't really like benefit anybody so I think it's important to do that actually and it's actually beneficial to the story because like that's like how like your audience gets burnt out is that it's like you're just like reusing like material and like you're just like you're not actually telling a story and like that's not really that interesting for very long and so I think that's kind of where Disney like found itself is that like they were like they weren't like actually like the way that they were like the structure of their like company was just like it had like an ulterior motive that was like working to the detriment of the company. And so I think that that's what happened, like what, like that's kind of just like how, like my assessment of like what was happening at Disney is that it's like they were like destroying like their like company by like having like again any like company organization a group of people is going to have like a like an end goal, you know? But like I think they Disney had such like a like. Kind of like Disney had such a like nefarious and like kind of like outdated and just like uninteresting agenda that like destroyed the company itself. And so just like Toy Story, like its audience didn't really want to play with the toys anymore. Like its audience didn't care about it anymore. Because like it they weren't like making content that was like that like actually like resonated with the audience in any way. They and it was just like old people like that it was old people more or less just like clinging to pictures of children that like were not children anymore. Like and so like they were clinging to like the, like not but again like those children are adults and like exist still, but like they aren't the children in the photos that like the company was like clinging to. So like that's what happens. Like those people were all alive. Those people were all like human beings. But like the like Mother Gothel was trying to make Rapunzel a little girl. Like that's what Disney was doing. Is that like Disney Junior is like has like these like little like kid shows on it that are stupid and uninteresting. And but like they're trying to like market that to like the adults that were children when like the picture of them got frozen. And it's like that's dumb. Like those people aren't children anymore, and like that's why the company is sinking. And so like the company, like if like Disney kind of I think found itself in like in a situation where they either had to like allow the company to like grow and mature to the point that like its audience had grown and matured to because they weren't really captivating like the same like the children that are like being raised that were the age that like Disney's magic captured, like they aren't capturing those children. Like the children that are being born now aren't like captivated by Disney the way that the children who were captivated by Disney at the height of its at the height of its you know, like at the height of the company, you know? Like they're not captivating the children that are being born now. And like they're not recaptivating the children who have grown because they're not appealing to them as the age that they are now. So it's like what Disney is facing is like what Disney is facing at the moment, it seems like is they are not capturing the magic of the children who are being born now, so they can't market to them. And that like that isn't working. And so they are also not making content that is mature enough to capture the people who like grew up with Disney. And so like they're at a place where it's like the values that they are trying to like force on people and like the agenda that they like are that like they that like the agenda that built the company is not sustaining the company. And so I think that that's what's happening is that it's like there's like it's kind of like a snake shedding its skin or like a or like grass regrowing like in Strange World and Lion King and in the Wish trailer. Like I think that that's what's happening is that it's like the Disney Corporation is clinging to like the dead grass of like the old people who are running the company. And like the people who are interested in Disney are interested in like the mature potential of Disney and not like the past, like the dead grass past of Disney. And so I think that that's what's happening. So it's like I like Disney. Like I like Disney films. I like the potential of Disney films, but like that's not what's manifesting on screen and nobody is seeing that. And so like all that's happening right now is like the toys are turning into plastic toys. Like it all looks plastic. And like the Marvel films all looks plastic. It all looks cheap. It all looks like trash. Because that's what it is. Because they're just toys now. They're not being like nobody actually wants to play with it. It's like they're just Toy Story toys that like nobody is interested in anymore. And like they have potential. It has potential, but like the magic is not like it's not interesting. Like it's not interesting in any way. And I think that that's what's happening is like the potential of the company is there and the potential of the company is interesting, but the company itself is dead grass right now. And I think that that's what's happening at Disney. Okay, so I'm just gonna like put this out there and see if it manifests. Asha, powers of manifestation. My villainous vocal quality. I love you. You're so funny. You're hilarious. You just earned it, bitch. I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding, but you did. You did though. But anyways, so yeah, so like it, I think what's happening in the Disney film, so Wreck-It Ralph Breaks the Internet came out, or Ralph Breaks the Internet came out in 2018. And so that film, like, kicked off these, like, the six, like, things that happened in Frozen 2. Anna even said, like, the ship disappeared 6 years ago. So, like, there's a, some sixth thing that's happening in Frozen. Also, I think she went to San Francisco. Like, she went to the future, I think. I think the future is what was calling her. And she said, grow yourself into something new. So, that has something to do with Big Hero 6 in San Francisco and the magic and the microbots that King Greenheart was attacking. And so, these six films, I think, are like, and also, there are like six immortal saplings in Knot's Autumn. So, I think these six films that have come out, like, in Frozen, that were referenced in Frozen 2 and that have come out since 2018, Wreck-It Ralph Breaks the Internet is 2018. Frozen 2 is 2019. And then like the coronavirus happened. And then like so I don't know if they're all like six consecutive years, but it is six films. So then like Frozen 2 was the second one. Raya and the Last Dragon is the third one. Encanto is the fourth one. Strange World is the fifth one. And Wish is presumably the sixth one. So, with that structure laid out, like Ralph Breaks the Internet, that came out, and then like the kingdom was not safe then, because like it was the water was on, and so then I turned the water on around the time either right after the Frozen trailer came out or right before, I don't know which. But I turned the water on in 2019, right at the end of Game of Thrones, and then the Game of Thrones enchantment dropped, and Wakanda opened, and we could see that the Iron Throne and the Wakanda throne are the same throne. It's so funny. It's an enchanted forest. So, like, that's what's happening, is that, like, the five films that have come out since 2019 are, like, the fifth spirit films that Elsa found in Autumn Hollow. So, like, the four spirits, I wonder if are arriving to Autumn. So, like, I wonder if, like, when she's open, she says, open your door in Frozen 2. So, presumably, the four films that remain are that follow Frozen 2, like, the four Disney animation films that follow Frozen 2 are the door opening, like, open your door four. You were the one you've been waiting for. So, I wonder if that's what's happening, is that it's, like, these four, like, so Ralph Breaks the Internet was like me like arriving to like a new place. Like that's when I went to that greenhouse in Marion. I said, come sit in my nosebleeds, best seats in the house. And I went to that greenhouse. So that was like Wreck-It Ralph Breaks the Internet. It's like I was in a new location. And so then in Frozen 2, that is the water being on. So Frozen 2, the water is on. And it says, open your door. So then there's four films coming out. And so the four films that are coming out are the spirits arriving to Alta Holland. So Elsa's in there in Frozen, but she's like, we were talking to each other from the future, and it was the future that was calling her. So I think the four spirits are arriving to Alta Holland, just that she woke the spirits of the Enchanted Forest. So those spirits are arriving to Alta Holland because she's talking to them from the future. So I think that that's what's happening, is that it's like the four films that are coming out after Frozen 2 are the four spirits. So I think that we'll see in the Wish film like the full manifestation of, because like that's what that's what the Lithia flag is. It's like four small like water buckets. Like it's like I poured water into the Lithia flag. And then it opens. She says, open your door. So like the four films are the water, are the flag being open. And like the signaling that the kingdom is becoming safe. It's not necessarily that it is safe, but I think that that's what it is. It's probably like they're like just like a self-destruct sequence, because that's kind of what the ta that's kind of what the Lithia flag is. It was many things, but it was also a self-destruct sequence. So I also think that like I built the tower subconsciously in such a way that if I had not returned to it by a certain period of time, it would self-destruct. Like it, because it also looks like an hourglass. So I think that that's kind of what that thing was. I think it is kind of a self-destruct button. But or a self-destruct like it's a self-destruct like mechanism. And so I think that that's actually what happened in Frozen 2. It's like she said, grow yourself into something new. Like the game has a delete button. And like the Ender's Game, like Ant Queen was telling me to like build a new world and like so I'll find a new home. And then like Man of Steel, she says, build a better world than we did. So they had been trying to get me to delete that thing for a while, I think. And so that was when the self-destruct sequence was like reaching the point where it's like, all right, we're deleting this, and we're gonna make something awesome, it's gonna be great. And we have. And so I think that that's what's happening in the Wish film. So the so like so Wreck-It Ralph Breaks the Internet is like the new location. Like the new me being in a new physical location. And it's also tracking, because you were like the sword and the stone thing, is like it was also tracking what were like the things that were happening, and like who were the pieces that were moving, and who were the players that were moving the pieces that were like actually like they were trying to see who it was, like they were looking for someone, Anastasia, like me. So like that's what was happening. Like Jasmine, I'm the lost princess, the seven majors. Like I'm Jasmine, seven, Jasmine, I'm the lost princess. Like that's what was happening. That's what, why it was like coronavirus. That's why it looks like Corona. So like Alta Holland presumably is like Corona. But like so I think that that's what was happening, is that like Eugene and Rapunzel went to Arendelle, and then we never saw them again. And then like Elsa is called to Alta Holland to grow herself into something new, because like Corona had not been like genuinely built. Like Eugene's telling a story, and in Tangled we see Corona built while he's telling the story, but like we had not seen Corona built in the Minecraft world. And so like maybe that's what was happening. He was like Runar was attacking the North Uldra leader because like my Fantasia power like had not like my Fantasia power had not like reconstructed Corona, even though I built Corona on with paint, like with the Microsoft Paint app, or I don't know, program, whatever. And I think that's also what's happening in that's also what's happening in Tron Legacy, is it's like a program. So like what exists now is like a more like intellectual version of what was happening in Tron Legacy. Even though Tron Legacy was quite beautiful on its own, but like where we are now is even more spectacular, and like Wakanda Forever is even, and Telecon is even more spectacular than that. And so I think that that's what was happening, is that it's like The like so Wreck-It Ralph is like the new location. They were seeing like we want to see just how we want to see just how absurd it can get. Like time is a stubbornly persistent illusion. That's absurd. Because it's me. It's Jacob Lattimore. Like the fifth spirit. It's Jacob Lattimore. And like they took me to so many like they took me to like various places in the map and in the region. And they were like, oh, like you literally like when they're authenticating this, like you literally built all this. Like yeah, I did. And like that's what was happening probably with my brain city. It's like they were like in Agrabah. It's like, oh, this whole palace is really just like your brain. It's like, yeah, it is. I told you that when I was born. And like you didn't believe something that I like told you when I was born. And now I have to sit here and talk to you because like you're trying to apologize so that I will know that so that I'll know that like you doubted me for no reason and like Uga Chaka. And I'm like, I don't care. I've known this my whole life. So it's like your apology isn't helping me at all. Like that's why you're in this enchanted forest, bitch. So like that's what's happening is that's why you got cursed, bitch. But like that's it's so funny. But anyways, but again, that's a joke. It's not real. I'm not actually like that. I don't actually curse people. I'm not an enchantress. I just do that like clobans. It's funny, and I think that's what's happening. It's like people are like I just like topsy-turvy day. Like your guys' lives are just hilarious, and so I just like pretend to do it because it's funny. But that's what's happening. But anyways. So I think that that's what's happening, not to all. And so Wreck-It Ralph Breaks the Internet is like the new location. Show Yourself, like Frozen 2, is like the water being on. So Raya and the Last Dragon is the like is kind of like one of the spirits arriving. Encanto is my like me having written something. So like that's one of my powers is I wrote an outline of or an atlas of like what Frozen 3 like how Frozen 3 could like play out or whatever. And then so like those two, the dam was up, but it was decided in Frozen 2 that the dam would be destroyed. But I don't know if that happened yet. And so then and so like Encanto and Raya are like the water like seeing the water being on. And then like people like kind of trying to like see who built it or whatever. And then like Encanto is like the writing and like the atlas of like what Frozen could be. And I also like it had kind of like some little like edits that I like posted on like my Facebook. And so like that was kind of just like me like kind of like exploring my power, exploring the light and Nautahala. And then like Strange World is like the dam actually being destroyed, which was decided in Frozen 2. So Strange World, the fifth one, is like the first like visual representation of like the dam being destroyed and like people seeing what like the and like the reveal, like the actual genuine reveal of the person who was found in Atahalan in Frozen 2, which was me. And so then Wish is going to be like the sixth one, which is like all four of the spirits having arrived to Atahalan. And I think that like there was also this little like ceremony that happened in like this like North Uldra scene that happened with Elsa and Anna where they learned that their parents were North Uldra or that Iduna was. And so I think what's probably going to happen in the Wish film is like Asha and Magnifico and like the like realms and like this battle and like the singing and like the like fight for your life and the sing for your life and the like speak your mind and live your life more true than this. Like I think that's what's like coalescing in the Wish film is like the four spirits are like actually arriving to Atahalan and we're seeing the open version of what was actually happening in Atahalan and like whatever spiritual coronation that Elsa was experiencing in Atahalan, we're probably actually going to see that in the Wish film, like in the open mist version of it. And so I think that that's what the Wish film is that like that's like the fourth spirit and probably like that's Elsa selecting like what spirit she is like either like going to like follow or which spirit she's going to like have as her like comrade or her companion or whatever. Like, I don't really know, but I think that they brought Elsa there to like select a spirit. And so like I selected the wind spirit. And I think Eros and Elsa are like selecting each other. And like Eros is also like receiving his voice. Cause I think Elsa either stole it or like I don't know if Elsa stole his voice or if Elsa is just like it's a calm manifestation of Eros because of what Callahan was doing in Big Hero 6. But I think that that's what's happening in the Wish film. It's like Elsa and Eros are like kind of selecting each other in the Wish film. The wind spirit is like what has been selected in the Wish film. And like I think also they're having to like Asha and Magnifico and Eugene, presumably. Like I think what's happening in the film, in the Wish film, is like they have selected the wind spirit, they've selected each other, like these kind of like four characters have selected each other and like selected the wind spirit. And I think maybe the film is them like presenting that to the community and seeing if they will like select this as well, or at least be open to the future manifesting with the selections that the powers that be have selected. Okay, so memories of magic are returning in Frozen 2. So I think also the Wish film, like I think the what's being revealed in the Wish film is that like because I revealed that the Fordish email was there and like then we deleted the Fordish email and then like we're showing like improvements in like brain functionality. It's the Wish film, and like Jafar is mind controlling Jasmine and Aladdin and the Sultan. And so the Wish film is the reveal and like the receiving of the memory of like mind control. And so I think that that's probably what's going to be prominently featured in the Wish film is that the mind control was happening, and like that's why my brain functionality has improved because the mind control is being like addressed.